Whirlpool refrigerator, right, guys, not right, cooling.
This is a Whirlpool. Oh no, my phone. Oh my goodness. Sorry guys, my phone. I'm trying to line it up. I'm doing a Whirlpool, and we are going to replace a compressor. Sorry about that. My phone started going crazy. Okay, so we're gonna take the back out of it. It's the back cover's gotta come out. I got all my stuff in. I got my torch. I got my vacuum. I got my my tools. I'm gonna cut some lines off. I'm gonna see some fire. It's gonna be some wonderful fire. So I'm gonna take all the back cover out. So the first thing I'm gonna do is the compressor. It's not cooling. So the first thing I am going to do is I'm gonna put up a purge valve so that we can release the gas. You have to have a safe way to release the gas. You have to have a vacuum. So this one here, what I'm gonna do is I am gonna purge the line here. I got a service valve so I can release the gas, and then afterwards I am going to remove the compressor. So it's fun, it's easy, it's not that complicated. Usually I'm able to do one like about an hour, maybe hour and a half. So there, got the line connected, and now I am going to attach my gauges, and I am going to release the gas. As soon as I open it up, you're gonna see the gas. The pressure will come off. That's letting me know that there's no leaks. If there's gas, if there was no gas, that means the system has a leak. But if you look at the gauge is, if you look at the blue one, the blue clock, it's like a little clock. If you look at it, you're gonna see it reaching. Yeah, see, it started moving. Look at that move. So next thing I'm gonna do, don't ever work on stuff without unplugging it. So I disconnected the starter. That's the starter from the compressor. That's from the old one. Right there, we're gonna remove that line on the one side and then another one on the other side. So right now I'm trying to remove the screws so that we can get it. That's the new compressor. The new compressor, yep, right there. Be careful with the new compressor. Make sure don't spill any oil, nothing. So right now I'm just gonna sand it up a little bit. Make sure you sand it, sand all the connections in there. So it doesn't have to be perfect, but I love to sand it. So it's easier for me to, whenever I do the bracing, it takes a real nice. So this is a Whirlpool compressor, and this one here is just the service valve so that we can recharge the unit. So the unit was not cooling. So that's the reason why we're replacing the compressor. It was not cooling at all. All the food went bad. So I don't know, but it happens quite often now. I noticed the Whirlpool. Yeah, so here's a new service valve. Don't get scared. Just my torch. This one I'm using a new tip. So I am kind of new to this tip, but I'm trying to put the new service valve in there. So just a little bit of fire, nothing big. It's amazing. Yeah, it's pretty fast once you get the hang of it. So yeah, and that is called the blue stick. Blue stick is like, it's connected with, it uses flux and silver soldering. And you just gotta heat it up a little bit, the copper. And once you heat up the copper, and the blue stick will do the rest of the work. Yeah. Oh, and make sure you always have, I don't know, if you have an old towel or an old shirt, just make sure you wet it. So that way you don't burn the floor or anything, or have anything. Some people use a special towel, but it's no, this one, you, as long as you wet the towel, you're fine. So right now I'm applying heat to it, and the flux is taking it. I'm just trying to go all the way around, make sure I don't have any leaks. I don't want to have any leaks. So there, yeah, just about finished there. You see the smoke? Yep, it's finished, it's done. So that's the new one. So the rest of it, yeah, you make sure you always, don't try to grab with your hand. So make sure you always, grab a towel. So here, over here, I am going to remove the old compressor. And I'm going to heat it up so that way I can go ahead. Yep. So then I got one more connection. I got that side out. So I am going to go ahead and move the other side. This is steel to copper. So you have to heat it up a little bit so that you can remove it out. This one here, it doesn't take much. So you just heat it up and eventually it'll come out. Sometimes a little bit of struggle, but it comes out. Yeah, sometimes you have to keep the heat close to the compressor. And yeah, just about coming out. So let me see. There is, just apply the fire close to the compressor, and then and use your pliers, and you can remove it. And just be, always be careful not to burn yourself. This is pretty simple. I mean, I've been doing compressors for a little while, and then there's not much to it. It's just got to remember the steps. Real simple, real easy, and yeah. So I got it out. See how I'm applying the that right there is just the old shirt that I had. It was, what I usually do is I wet it, and then I have a 2x4 right now. Sometimes so what I do is I put the 2x4, I can set my tools on top of it so that way it doesn't burn the floor or anything. So that is the new compressor in, and I am going to go ahead and do the connections, go ahead and brace the connections. So what helps me do this pretty fast is, you know, sanding the connection, doing... make sure you sand the connection. So see, that one's finished. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the next one. And you know, make sure you don't have any leaks. You know, after this, after I'm done with that, I'm gonna go ahead and vacuum the unit. You know, that way it makes sure there's no leaks. And usually I vacuum it for between 10 to 20 minutes. I usually do it. It depends. So see right there, it's finished pretty fast. So now take a look, make sure we don't have any cracks or anything like that. Make sure there's no openings, so that way, yeah, you got to have a little mirror in there, so you know, that way you can check. But this is, you know, this is more like practice. You know, you know, if you ever done it before, you know, you can watch some videos. And this here, you know, I have a license to actually do something like that, so I'm able to buy, you know, some stuff. Here, we got the gas there ready to go. I got the scale ready to go. How do you know how much gas you got to put in? You have to take a look at the model. The model in this one is calling for 5.5, ounce of 3 amp. But yep. So we got the gas in there, and now we're checking for temperature. So the temperature is looking good. It's looking good. And you know, 37, it usually takes about 24 hours to definitely cool down. So that's pretty much it, guys. This is it. This is beautiful. Don't forget to make sure to subscribe to the channel, follow up for more videos, you know, show the love, make sure, you know. And then this, you know, video is, you know, it's just to show you that anything, it can be fixed. Anything can be fixed.